Good morning, students. Welcome to today's session. Today we are going to discuss a very important aspect of that we use in our English grammar, that is of phrasal verbs. So in our day-to-day conversation, we so many times use phrasal verbs which we might even not have noticed. So what actually is phrasal verb? Phrasal verbs are the verbs on which we add a preposition or an adverb to make it a phrase. What the phrase is actually about is different from the meaning that it conveys. So let's discuss this topic in detail through an exercise and a PPT that we are going to share. So let's start the presentation. So today the topic is of phrasal verbs, and what does phrasal verbs actually mean are phrases that indicate action. A phrasal verb is an idiomatic phrase consisting of a verb and another element. Then element can be a preposition or an adverb. So an adverb, for example, if you take an example of break down. So break is what? Break is verb, and how it is breaking down is the adverb. If you talk about break down, it's an adverb altogether. And if you talk about preposition, when we are adding preposition to a verb, it becomes a phrasal verb, like see to. See is verb and to is preposition. We can again use both adverb as well as preposition in a phrasal verb. For example, look down on. Now, phrasal verb consists of a verb and a preposition or an adverb, as I already told you. There are some examples given over here. These are all verbs: get, go, write and take. These all are verbs because some action is being performed and we have to put either a preposition or an adverb to make it a phrasal verb. Get up means getting up early in the morning, rising from the bed. Go through, well, we go through some due course of action. Write down, this means pen down, write something. Take after, like we take after someone in the sequence or in a hierarchy. Sometimes phrasal verb consists of three elements. This, as we already discussed, that once we can have only verb, then we can add preposition or adverb, or we can have both of it. Preposition as well as adverb, or preposition 1 and preposition 2. So examples are given here. Look forward to, put up with, sit in for. So these all together make a phrasal verb, and it does signify a particular meaning to the phrasal verb. When added to the verb, the preposition or the adverb may change completely the meaning of the verb. This is very important. Yes, it happens that whenever we have to use a phrasal verb, it is not exactly the meaning of the words that are being used. It is used as a phrase. So some of the examples are here. Look for. Look for means to search or to seek. So look for something in the maybe in the cupboard, or I am looking for my keys is one of the examples. Look up to. When we idolize somebody, when we say we respect somebody, at that time we can use the phrase look up to. Example being given here. His father is his model, role model. He is the person he looks up to. So we can say we look up to our army in the times of crisis. Again is one of the appropriate usage of this phrase. Next comes look forward to. Means we are eagerly waiting for something to happen or somebody to come. She is looking forward to visit Paris. Yes, we are looking forward to our budget. Right? We can make such sentences ourselves. Look up. Look up means to search for some piece of information, as we generally say look up for this word in the dictionary. So same goes here, to try to find a piece of information by looking in the book or in a computer or in a dictionary. She didn't understand the word, so she looked up it in her dictionary. Now, phrasal verbs can be divided into two groups. One is transitive verbs and one is intransitive verbs. So transitive verbs, I hope you remember, that are the verbs which take an object, and intransitive verbs are those which does not have any object in them. So further, transitive verbs can be divided into more main groups: separable verbs and inseparable verbs. So let's discuss it in detail. What are intransitive verb phrasal verbs? An intransitive phrasal verb cannot be followed by an object. This means it completes sense of a sentence without using any object. Example is here, he suddenly showed up. What is showed up? Means he came. So he suddenly came. There is no object in this sentence and neither is there any requirement. So in such a case, it is an intransitive phrasal verb. Tony's car broke down. So broke down is a phrasal verb. Jane grew up in a small town. So grew up again is a phrasal verb, and we do not require any object in these sentences. Next is transitive phrasal verbs. A transitive phrasal verb is followed by an object, as we usually use in our sentences. I made up the story. So made up is what? Made up is a phrasal verb and story is an object. So what are we making up? We are making a story. So that's why I made up the story is a correct use of a transitive phrasal verb. Are you writing down these notes? So writing down is what? Is a phrasal verb. And these notes, the notes is what? Is object. I haven't called Mr. Wilson back. So again, just pay attention here. I haven't called Mr. Wilson back. So what is the phrasal verb here? The phrasal verb is called back. So whenever we have an object, we can use the object in between the phrasal verb by separating the two parts of the phrasal verb like this. So how we can do it, when we should do it, we will discuss in the later slides. Next, a few examples of intransitive phrasal verbs and transitive phrasal verbs. So first is get up. As we know, we are rising from the bed, that is get up. So examples are, I don't like to get up early. Now where is the object required? We don't require any object here. That's why it is intransitive phrasal verb. Next, we discussed the same kind of example before also. He was late as his car broke down, means ceased to function. Next, we will discuss transitive phrasal verbs, a few examples of it. Put off means to postpone something. We will have to put off the meeting. So what are we going to put off? We need to tell about the object. The object is the meeting. Next is turn down. Somebody turns down our proposal. So that means he has refused our proposal. So they turned down my offer. So what have they turned down? What have they refused? My offer. So without adding this object, we cannot make a sensible sentence here. That is why we require an object, and it is known as transitive phrasal verb. Next, as we already discussed, that we have two different parts in transitive phrasal verbs. One is separable and one is inseparable. So separable means when we can separate the phrasal verb into two parts, right? So example is, please turn off the TV. Is the correct sentence? Turn off is a phrasal verb. Can we say, please turn the TV off? Yes, we can, and it is again correct. So what we have done is turn the TV off. So the TV is the object, and we are putting the object within the phrasal verb. So turn and off, we can separate, and the sentence still is correct. Same is example given here. Subject is they. Verb is turned down my offer. Is a simple sentence where we are using the phrasal verb together, right? Then we can use it in a different way as well, like they turned my offer down. So the object is in between turned and down. It is known as separable phrasal verbs, separable transitive phrasal verbs. Now when we can separate, there are conditions when we can separate a phrasal verb. So phrasal verb can be actually separated whenever the object is very small, is just of a few words, say not more than four words. Example is here, Mr. Wilson called off his appointment. So what is the object here? His appointment. Called off is phrasal verb. So how we can just separate the phrasal verb here? Mr. Wilson called his appointment off. So this is a correct sentence and the correct use of phrasal verb. Next condition when we can separate it is when we are using the phrasal verb as a specific, by its specific name of a thing or the person. Example is here, I threw away the old pizza. Now it's a specific thing we are talking about. We are talking about old pizza. So we can use it in between. I threw the old pizza away. Right? Otherwise, if we just don't have to break it, we can simply write, I threw away the old pizza. Both are correct. When not to separate the phrasal verb? So what are the conditions when we don't have to separate? Definitely, this object is longer than four words. As I already told you, that whenever the object is small, like it is maybe of two, three or four words, then we can just add object in between the phrasal verb. Otherwise, we need not separate because then it will be incorrect. Example is here. Mr. Wilson called off his 3:30 appointment with Dr. Smith. Is correct. So can we change it? Can we break it? Mr. Wilson called his 3:30 appointment with Dr. Smith off. This is incorrect because the length of the object is too long. So we cannot separate it. Next is inseparable phrasal verbs and the examples of them. Yesterday, I ran into Alan. Is correct. Yesterday, I ran into him is again correct. But if we write in between, yesterday, I ran Alan into or I ran him into, that is wrong because we cannot use in between the noun or the pronoun within the phrasal verb. So it cannot be possible. Now, phrasal verbs convey different meanings. It's not always that whenever we are using a phrasal verb, it's going to give us literal meaning. Most of the times, it is going to convey a different meaning altogether. So, see what changes, what different meanings we can get. Put off means to postpone, as we have already discussed. So, he put off the meeting till tomorrow. So, he has postponed the meeting till tomorrow. Put on, to cover your body with clothes. Put on your dress, otherwise you'll feel cold. Put back. This means to return something back to its original position. So put back the books on the shelf. Right. Next is put away. To put something in its original position. So one is that we are returning something just by adding back and away. The meaning of both the phrases change. Some phrasal verbs have more than one meaning. Yes. As we can see here, a few examples. There are many more. Keep on and keep on. One is keep on doing your quality work. This means continue doing it. Keep on, not to remove something. So we will say keep this on. Don't try to fiddle with it. So this is again one of the examples. Take off means remove. Take off your shoes. They're full of mud. Next is take off. When the plane takes off, so it leaves. So again, same spelling but different meanings. These are very important topics of phrasal verbs which we all must focus on in our day-to-day conversation because it's very important that we use phrasal verb in the right context and give correct meanings to our conversation as well as to our writings. I hope you understood this topic of phrasal verbs and will definitely practice at home more exercises based on phrasal verbs. Thank you. All the best to you.